Hey, welcome to my Hobbies Are Not Cheap channel. Today we'll be learning how to replace a friction staff on a Ball Waltham pocket watch. I bought this pocket watch a while back and had a broken staff in it, so now we're going to replace it. So let's get started. Well, a balance staff finally came in the mail. It's the 4861 Waltham balance staff. It's the same balance staff that Waltham uses in their Crescent Streets and their Vanguard pocket watch. Well, I'm going to let down the mainspring. I'm using my little piece of pegwood and pushing the click out of the way so I can use my bench tool to unwind the mainspring so we can get started taking this thing apart. Let's look at the balances that they sent. I hope these are pretty good. Last time I ordered some, they look kind of rusty. I don't know. I guess it was old stock and I ended up not using them. But this looks pretty shiny. I'm looking at it underneath the microscope. I have the digital microscope that I use to inspect jewels and really small parts. Looks like there's a little bit of something on the very tip of it. Some dirt or something. Let's see if we can clean that off. Now what I'm going to use to clean the tip of it is it's called pithwood, and I just stick the tip of the balance staff into that and it cleans off any debris that's on the end of it. You can get that pithwood at any watch supply distributor online. It's real handy to have, something that you really need. Looks like it cleaned it off pretty good. Now we're going to take our balance out. Well, now we got our balance off. I'm setting it on that piece of pithwood again. Now we need to take the balance wheel off the balance cock. I'm loosening the screw that holds the balance wheel on. Got it off. Now I'm going to tighten that screw up so I don't lose that screw. I'm going to set the balance cock to the side. And now we're going to take the hairspring off the balance wheel. Get our hairspring removal tools and gently pry up on it, very gently. You don't want to damage that hairspring. Well, now we have our staking tool set out and we're going to be using our center punch to center up our die plate so we can put our stump on there, a special stump that's used for removing the roller table off the balance wheel. This is the stump we'll be using. And this is the stake that we'll be using to knock the roller table off of the balance wheel. We just take that stake, very gently push it down on top of that. You can see how it holds it in just a little tap. That's all it takes, is a little tap. We're going to put our parts into a little container so we don't lose them. And oops, I hate when that happens. I have to fish it out of there. Be very careful that we don't damage our roller jewel. the balance wheel, and you see that black part I'm pointing to? That's called the hub, and that's where your staff goes through, and that's the friction part that holds the staff inside the balance wheel. And what we'll be doing is knocking that out. I'm going to use this tool as my stump. You can see how it's rest on there, and that fits perfectly in there. I invert that into my staking tool set. I set my balance on top of it. Just a light tap and knock that staff right out of there. I like the friction fit better than I do the riveted kind, which I'll probably do a video on how to remove a riveted staff from a balance. There you go. There's the old staff right there. Okay, now we're going to put our new staff in our balance. We get everything lined up. Take our punch. Just tap it down. Little tap, light tap. That's all it takes. You want to take your time doing this too. It's not a race. See how fast you can do it. You go fast, you mess things up. Now we're going to try out our new staff just to see. We don't have our hairspring or roller table installed, but we're just going to put it in the movement and put the balance cock on there and see how it spins around, if everything's okay. Looks good so far. Using a little air puffer thing to spin it around, see how it spins. Spinning really well. So let it spin. If it spins about 10 seconds, we're good to go. Well, everything looked good, so now we're going to put it all back together. Now we'll be putting our roller table back onto our balance wheel. Now I'll be using this stake here to push on the roller table. You can see that little cutout that's in there. That's to protect the roller jewel from being damaged. tap that down, get it seated good and solid on the staff. Now we're going to put the bottom part of our roller table on, get it lined up. There we go, everything's good in line. We're going to use this type of punch to push that little piece down on top of the other one. Line everything up good. There we go. Just a real light tap. Now it's time to put our hairspring back on our balance wheel. And we're going to use the same punch that we used before on the roller table when we used it to push down the roller table. We just gently slide it down. You have to be very careful on this. You don't want to damage your hairspring. You just do a very light tap. Okay, we got it all back together. Now let's put it on the balance cock. Get everything attached like it should be. Our balance put back together. Now let's put it back into our movement and see how everything worked out. Looking good so far. The balance is swinging a little bit. Yep, looks good. Let's give it a wind up and see if it starts right up. Yeah, good. Job well done. If you'd like to learn more about how to use a staking tool for watch repair, watch this video.